ISIS.
The first of three public meetings held by the Department of Justice is underway in southwest Albuquerque. KOAT Action 7 News reporter Ana Velasquez is live from the Alamosa Community Center.
Well, the DOJ says that these community meetings are crucial in moving forward towards rebuilding trust in APD from the public. Now, a few weeks ago, the DOJ did release its findings and found that APD has a use of excessive force, including deadly force. It also found that APD's community policing is inadequate, and in turn, that created a mutual distrust between officers and the community. But they say tonight's meeting, that's why they want to hear from residents on how to reform APD. One man says holding officers accountable is a start.
They just let them get away with it. They don't let them do it. They let them do what they want, you know, because of the waivers of the city and all these other things. They need to hold them accountable like any other person, and they're not doing that.
Now, this meeting runs until 7 o'clock tonight, and this is the start. The DOJ and the city of Albuquerque creating a court-enforceable agreement. The DOJ is expected to release its preliminary recommendation sometime in May. Reporting live from southwest Albuquerque, I'm Ana Velasquez, KOAT Action 7 News.
And we'll have a full wrap-up of that meeting coming up tonight at 10. If you didn't make it to this meeting, you'll have two more chances this week. The next public meeting is tomorrow at Palo Duro Senior Center, and the last one is Wednesday at the Cesar Chavez Community Center. All the meetings will run from 5 to 7 p.m. You can also call or email the Department of Justice. We have that information for you at KOAT.com. Just look under the As Seen on 7 section.
Albuquerque Police Officer.